Welcome to an introduction to combinatorial proofs. Explanatory proofs are typically called combinatorial proofs. In general, to give a combinatorial proof for a binomial identity, say A equals B, we do the following. Number one, we find a counting problem to answer in two ways. Number two, we explain why one answer to the counting problem is A. And then three, we explain why the other answer to the counting problem is B. Since both A and B are the answers to the same question, we must have A equals B. The tricky part is coming up with the question. In this lesson, we'll take a look at two combinatorial proofs for the binomial identity n choose k is equal to n minus 1 choose k minus 1 plus n minus 1 choose k. In the previous lesson, we proved this is true using an algebraic proof. One way to see the equation is true is to consider bit strings. N choose k is a number of bit strings of length n containing k1s. Some of the bit strings start with a 1 and the rest start with a 0. First consider all the bit strings which start with a 1. After the 1, there must be n minus 1 more bits to get a total length of n, and exactly k minus 1 of them must be 1s, as we already have 1, 1, and we need a total of k1s. How many strings are like that? Well, there are exactly n minus 1 choose k minus 1 such bit strings. Of all the length n bit strings containing k1s, n minus 1 choose k minus 1 of them start with a 1. Similarly, there are n minus 1 choose k which start with a 0. We need n minus 1 bits, and now k of them must be 1s. Since there are n minus 1 choose k bit strings containing n minus 1 bits with k1s, that is the number of n bit strings with k1s, which start with a 0. We answered the same question in two different ways, so the two answers must be the same. Therefore, n choose k is equal to n minus 1 choose k minus 1 plus n minus 1 choose k. So this would be one possible combinatorial proof for the binomial identity. Let's take a look at a second combinatorial proof. So here's another way to explain why the equation is true. How many ways can you select k pizza toppings from a menu containing n choices? One way to do this is to evaluate n choose k. Another way to answer the same question is to first decide whether or not you want anchovies. If you do want anchovies, you still need to pick k minus 1 toppings from now n minus 1 choices. This can be done in n minus 1 choose k minus 1 ways. If you do not want anchovies, then you still need to pick k toppings from n minus 1 choices. The anchovies are out. You can do that in n minus 1 choose k ways. Since the choices with anchovies are disjoint from the choices without anchovies, the total choices are n minus 1 choose k minus 1 plus n minus 1 choose k. So once again, we answered the same question in two different ways, so the two answers must be the same. N choose k equals n minus 1 choose k minus 1 plus n minus 1 choose k. I hope you found this helpful.